Between July the 25th and September the 23rd, 2001, the people of the southern India state of Kerala witnessed, on numerous occasions, an extraordinary sight: blood-colored rain. Eyewitnesses also reported that accompanying the early instances of colored rain were loud thunderclaps and flashes of lightning. Further, following the rain's first appearance, many trees shed their leaves, with the leaves turning gray and appearing to be burned. Whether any of these reports were exaggerated or not, the colored rain was a scientific curiosity, and as scientists are wont to do, they got to studying the phenomena. Early on, it was determined that in each millimeter of rain, about 9 million red particles could be found. However, corroborating the stories of those who reported other colored rain, it was found that while most particles were red, there were some that were tinted green, bluish-gray, and yellow. The Center for Earth Science Studies in Kerala, which learned that the pH of the rain was neutral, also found that it had large amounts of nickel, manganese, titanium, chromium, and copper in it. The red particles themselves were determined to be mostly carbon and oxygen, with a small amount of iron and silicon. This led to the center at first attributing the likely cause of the colored rain to be an exploding meteor. However, further research showed that the particles contained spores. While there was quite a bit of hoopla over some researchers speculating that the spores may have had extraterrestrial origin, given initial reports of lack of any DNA found and some still going with the exploding meteor idea, in fact, the Tropical Botanical Garden Research Institute eventually found that the particles were spores of a lichen-forming alga belonging to the genus Trentifolia. Indeed, they believed that these spores had come from local sources. They opined that heavy rains preceding the events triggered widespread growth of the lichens, which in theory would have increased the number of spores in the air. However, while that was their best guess, they noted that they thought it unlikely that the lichens would simultaneously release enough of the spores to account for the colored rain. They further were baffled at how the spores would have risen so high in the atmosphere, as no nearby recent weather phenomenon seemed a likely culprit to have caused such an upswell. Approximately a decade and a half after the event, some of the mystery may have actually been solved. In 2013, scientists continuing to study the event not only found the missing DNA, but not long after, researchers revealed that the precise species of the algae was Trentifolia annulata, which was not native to India, hence explaining why no local weather phenomenon around that time explained how the spores got so high in the atmosphere. The researchers ultimately speculated that the spores were introduced through the clouds from Austria. Of course, weird rains are nothing new to history. As we've covered before, Kentucky even had a cloudy with the chance of meatballs-like rain in 1876, when chunks of meat literally rained from the sky. Moving more recently in history, in early 2015, a strange milky rain fell on parts of Idaho, Oregon, and Washington. Scientists eventually learned it was caused by a dust storm from southern Oregon, where the dust had a high amount of saline, similar to the composition of milk. Going back to relatively ancient times, Greek philosopher Heraclides Lembus, 2nd century BCE, recorded a rain that included so many frogs falling from the sky that the houses and the roads have been full of them. While you might think this couldn't actually have happened, in better documented times, from 2005, a small town in Serbia had a rain of non-native frogs, some of which actually survived. The primary hypothesis for why frogs, or fish, or snakes, stones, meat, maggots, etc., occasionally fall from the sky is that waterspouts or tornadoes suck them up and then drop them somewhere else. While this hypothesis hasn't been definitively proven for small animal rain, it's not unheard of for small animal-sized objects to be picked up by tornadoes and then travel even as far as 50 to 200 miles before being deposited back on solid ground. Note, too, when talking about extremely light objects like large dust particles that have been documented traveling thousands of miles and falling in rain, including yellow dust from the Gobi Desert falling on Washington State in 1998, 5,600 miles or 9,000 kilometers away, and Saharan dust has even been known to travel across the Atlantic Ocean. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do give us a thumbs up below, and don't forget to subscribe. We've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. If you're looking for something else to watch right now, check out a video on the screen from the archives. And as always, thank you for watching.